Hey everybody, we are back with another episode of Baldur's Gate 3. We're about to enter to the ruins through this ornate door because we deceptivized. we lied and said that someone was in trouble, so now we can go and enter through here instead of having to go through here. This way is an interesting way because you wind up in a room, but you're going to come out and wind up in a fight right outside the door, and it's kind of an inconvenient positioning, so this is the better way, I think, to go. And unfortunately, our old dude here got ensnared and got some damage on him, so he can't really do that much. But he does have mage armor on. In fact, I may want to go ahead and camp because he's out of spells and he's to rest at a camp to get those replenished. And I think the same kind of holds true for what's her face here, Shadowheart. So let's go ahead and camp real quick. Guy's just got a mirror image of himself up. Yeah, what are you doing?
Indulging in a spot of vanity. Handsome devil art.
Oh, totally.
Be that as it may.
Seramorphosis. What does it make you think of?
Let's see. That damn tadpole.
Spot on. Day one, fever and memory loss. Day two, hallucinations and graying skin. Day three, hair loss and blood leaking from all orifices.
Ouch.
Need to go on?
Shake your head.
My point is this. Our orifices remain blissfully unblooded, our heads remain clear, and our blood temperature normal. Any expert will agree, this is abnormal.
Let's see, can you explain why the symptoms aren't showing?
That, alas, is where my knowledge fails me. A rogue might call it luck, a priest might call it fate. As for myself, I'm a pragmatic. I see the silence before the storm.
Ooh.
Something to sleep on. We should get some rest.
I agree. Okay, are there any spells that I need to do something with? What does she got? We want to get anything else. Should we take one out to replace another? Keep thinking we need to take one of these, maybe one of these healings off. Oh, I definitely do want to switch out grease. Let's take off grease and put on magic missile. Good. And for her, we need to probably take off. This targets up to three creatures. That's a good one. I like it. This create water actually comes in useful sometimes. Take sand. Just trying to see. Cure wounds, healing word. Cure wounds, healing word. 1d3. So we'll take this one off. And let's see, what else do you want to add? Oh, a bless. Bless might be very come in very handy. Let us do that. Alright, I think we're good with these spells. Everyone else is fine. And yeah, I guess we'll go ahead and rest. Just get his healing back up and get these spells memorized. What is that creepastarian doing? Looking for blood, I bet. Okay, there's our quick save. Let's head on in. We just surprised someone, didn't we? We did. Time to perhaps, yeah, get right here. I like to get in a position where a Starion can get around. Asterion is the next to go up, so I need to probably come around here. Right here. What the hell was that? You missed! Wait. That's fine. Whatever, man. Alright, Asterion. Can we perhaps come back here and give this guy a nice backstab? Maybe. Alright, so a sneak attack. Exploit a foe's distraction to deal 1d8 plus 3 plus 1d6 piercing. They'll get an attack save for a melee attack. And prerequisites, you have an advantage, or another enemy of the target is within 1.5 meters of it, and you don't have disadvantage. We're just threatened, that's it. I think this will count as a sneak attack. Oh, that was beautiful. Could have taken him out in one hit, unfortunately, but we didn't. Alright, so this guy does not have any kind of dark vision. He's just a normal, stupid human. Duh. So, I don't want to use any spells on him, per se, so we'll just give him maybe a whack. Maybe a topple. There he goes. And, yeah. Let's get this over here and lock that up. Actually, this should go down here. There we go. Alright, we're done with your turn. It's my turn. Let's go and finish this guy off. Asterion, can you loot him up? He's got him a key. Some leather armor. It's good. Alright, now we're just going to do a quick loot of the place. And I'm not going to show you all the looting because it's going to be pretty boring. But if I come across anything interesting, I'll let you guys know. Alright, be back in just a second. Alright guys, we are back. Just finished looting up this entire area, and yeah, got a bunch of junk, got everything distributed between everyone, and now we're ready to rarin, and we're gonna open this door and encounter some hostilities. And I want to get everyone kind of prepared for what's coming. Be great if we kind of get everyone... Oh, we can open up this door through here. I thought for some reason I had to pick that lock, but okay. Let's try to get everyone situated here. I need you to come up here. No, let's separate. Everyone separate. There we go. No. Stay up here. Shadowheart. Kind of want you to stay up here with him. And then Corpse will have you potentially here. No. Thank you. Alright, we need to cast some spells on this guy. We need to give him the blessing of the trickster. Let's see. Seems like blessing would kind of help. I thought we had blessing. We do have bless. Yeah, right there. We may get that started soon. Let's see. Probably when combat starts. Okay, Shadowheart, back up here. Thank you. You go sneaky. And let's get this combat started. Okay. So we see there is an oil. There's a wooden barrel there. Be great if we get our... Let's get our arrows... dipped in some fire here. Nope, not that. Wanted the arrows. Let's go ahead and dip that again. There we go. Fire arrows. That's what I wanted, baby. About to get this thing kicked off here by just firing a little sneaky arrow right in there. let's get up. Hopefully this fire arrow will work. It's not a fire arrow. Can I dip it over here? Yes, we can. There we go. Cool. Try to get him away from the... Okay, corpse is in the battle now. Okay, we can end that turn. They're surprised. So let's go ahead and surprise them again with some fire. Right there. There we go. Have you... Move over here. Thank you. And hide. There we go. Yes, burn! Burn! Everyone burn! Did a shot for corpse. Missed, luckily. What do we got? What do we got? We have a 30% chance of hitting him. I am going to go over here. Get some flames on my arrows. There we go. See, unfortunately, we can do a dash, come back and kind of get back in the action. Come on. Okay. All right, Asterion's turn. Actually, we need to get these two jerks into the combat. I thought they were. They are in the combat. Okay. Now, I wonder if I can get a grease bottle. Right into there. Didn't look like it was going to affect me like that, but apparently it did. Come back just a little bit more, and we're going to... Well, that's all we can do right now. That's fine. Guess we can try to hide again. Nope, he's in the line of sight. That's fine. Someone just died. Barton. Marie has a little bit left on her. I sure would like to get some fire going here. So... kind of want to do some blessing. There we go. There we go. We're all blessed. She's going to get down in hide mode and end her turn. All right. We need to definitely get this set on fire. And what perfect timing. There you go. Hesad took a lot of damage on that one. I like to see that. Tent, we can get him over here. And end his turn. Taking pot shots at a boy back here. Do I have any, I do have somewhat of a target on him, but I need to move just a little bit more. Just 36%. That's pretty much all we have right now. Let's go ahead and get him a pin down. Maybe perhaps we can get this. Oh, and he is pinned down. Good. This guy's got poison loaded up on him. It's a good miss. Thank goodness. He's pinned down. He's also on fire, I think. No, he's just pinned down. Better shot on her back there, but it means I have to come back just a little bit forward. Oh, bad miss. All right, let's get you. A little dash. Let's get you out of the way. How about there? We command him to halt. Oh no. That never works. They always make their saving throws. Come here and die. I don't think so. Not yet, at least. Alright. This guy has 6 hit points left. Maybe another firebolt may dissuade him. It's only a 36% chance of hitting, though. What about Witchbolt? 36% chance as well. Ray of Frost? 60, that's better. Oh, well. Looks like it knocked him down, though. That's good, at least. Woo! Let's see. Can we get a good... This doorway's burning. That's always a good sign. Anything in our inventory that can potentially help us out? Mage armor, scroll of firebolt. I wonder if we could throw one of these void bulbs or... Spiked bulb. I wonder what this does. Let's see what this does real quick. Oops. I don't know. I don't know what this thing does. I guess we can go and just fire. 42%. Good hit. And, yeah. Oh, of course he got hit. Of course. Do you have an antidote? Anything? Let's see. You got basic poison there. Hold on. Consumables. Some healing. Water. Yeah, nothing. No antidotes, it looks like. So it looks like our boy here is probably going to go down here pretty soon. We do need to... Perhaps get him out of the way. Move him back here. And get him a healing potion. Wanted to use it. Action bar. There we go. Should keep him on his toes just a little bit longer. All right. Perhaps we can get a... Bane going. Someone didn't get it. I can't see their statuses. I only see this guy's status, so I assume that Bane didn't work at all. It's time to... I wish I had, use this? Probably not. Before the frigid beam of blue-white light deals 1d8 golden... Okay, yeah. That's cool. All right, get this guy. That didn't do shit to him. Great. Perfect. Can you come up here? There we go. Oh, of course. Why wouldn't you miss? go ahead and just the 36%, and it's just really bad. It's because he's got the hide advantage, but it's really kind of weird how it's working. Sacred Flame, perhaps, or something? Thank you. Did something. Oh, great! Hey! He just took his, what is it called? He just took his second wind to give him more hit points. That's perfect. Oh, that's so good. All right, well, how about some magic missiles? And he missed that one. All right, since this guy's in range, let's just try to whack on him. There he goes. That turn, Marie, you're next. Come on in. Oh, you don't like our wizard. Oh, now you're running back? You little scoundrel. She is out. That's what I like to see. I may have to push what's her face up here. Bad miss. Sephiri's finally moving. Let's get our mage as far as he can over here. Okay, got some damage on her. I have anyway path interrupted. And I think the path's interrupted over here. Yep, so you can't do anything. Let's see if we can bludgeon her down. Oh, come on. That would have been great. Ouch. Put another magic missile. Gone. Where you going, buddy? You get a pot shot off at me? Oh, you got a crit. That was perfect. None of us are dead, though. I don't think we are. No. That crit hurt, but at least we're not dead. Alright, let's, perhaps we can go ahead and take that second wind or the action surge. Yeah, let's do the action surge. And let's go and main hand attack this guy. Too far. Okay. Guess we'll just shoot at him then. Keep missing, guys. It's okay. We can draw this battle, you know, as much as you would like. Okay. Let's go and just firebolt this guy. Hopefully it'll hit. Nope. Let's just keep taking the battle out. Let's do it. How long can it last? Possibly not that much longer. Oh, yes. Let's make it last just a little bit more longer. Oh, of course he gets a hit on her. That makes total sense. Thank you. Holy fever, dude. That was a painful, very painful bout. She needs to heal up, but she has no spell slots available. She's used all her spells. very greedy that way. But let's have her. Let's see, who can pick up stuff? All right, we need our wizard to start picking up some stuff. Okay. Who else? Anyone else here? We can go and check. Mari. Ringmail armor. I think the best armor of the game is the one that Corpse is wearing, which was Lizelle's. But I think that's going to be about it. Thanks for joining me, guys. That last battle was more of an annoyance than... I'm not going to say it was entirely fun. I think I could have taken a better strategy at it. I'm not sure what I could have done. You know, maybe I'll replay it a couple of times just to see. But yeah, it was just more of an annoyance. A lot of misses, a lot of stuff going on. We got to remember that humans don't have great night vision. So when they're always going at a disadvantage unless there's plenty of light in the air. You can see it's dark right now. If we go to Corpse, he's got dark vision. Asterion has some dark vision, and so does Shadowheart. Yeah, but that's about it. We're going to take a short rest, get some of our hit points back, and we're going to continue on from here. But that'll be in another episode. For right now, thank you for joining me. And hey, if you enjoyed this episode, you hear my weird meandering commentary, go ahead and hit that like, I guess. Leave a comment below, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.